Welcome to Wedding Wednesdays with Plum Crafty. My name is Cherie, and today we're going to do a little wedding DIY that's very cost effective for any brides out there trying to save a little bit. If you're wanting to do some of your own centerpieces, and say you have these clear vases and you know you want something more than just the regular stones or glass beads or anything like that, you can jazz these up a little bit. Like I said, these are from the Dollar Tree. And you can coordinate some of your wedding colors this way. We're going to be working today with craft wire, and you can use different gauges. I would suggest 12 gauge to maybe 14, 16 at the smallest, just because the smaller you go, the easier that the wire is to bend. The 12 gauge is nice. It holds its shape. That's actually what I'm going to be using today, the 12 gauge. It's bendable, but it does hold its shape. So all you're going to need to do this is, of course, your Dollar Tree vase, some wire cutters, some flat nose pliers, almost dropped that, and of course your wire, your vase, and either a hot glue gun or some glue dots if you want to have those. You don't have to. So what you're going to do first is you're going to want to cut a length of wire. I'm actually working with a 5 foot length piece of wire. And that might sound like a lot, but it's not. You're going to take your wire with your flat nose pliers. You're going to take that and start to bend it in on top of itself. See if you can see that here. And you're just going to want to keep twirling that around. And you'll see why. You're going to make like a little curly cue kind of thing here. And that's going to actually sit flat up against your vase. And that's just to kind of like finish it off a little bit, so you just don't have a piece of wire just sitting there sticking out at the bottom of your vase. And you can make this little curly part as big or as small as you want. You can even, if you want to get a little bit more adventurous, you can put some more designs in it. You can do some little extra wiggle waggle, whatever you want to do for that. We're going to stop here. So it's going to be about this big here. So you want to take that. You want to take your vase in one hand, wire in the other hand. You're going to lay this flat up against your vase so you kind of have an idea where it is. Now, if you want this facing down, face it down. If you want it to face up, face it that way. Now, once you get that started, you're going to start just wrapping the wire around your vase. And it doesn't really have to be, you know, you don't have to space it out or try to do anything fancy with the design right this second. You just want to get it to go around your vase. Now, when you're done, you're going to want to stop and leave probably about a foot of this wire here. It's about 12 inches there. You want to take that off your vase. And then you're going to take your flat nose pliers, and at this end, do the same thing as at the beginning. You're going to want to twirl that around. And again, you can make that as big or as small as you want and put whatever designs you like in there. Like I said, this wire is really easy to bend, works very well. And if you think that you've messed up or you want to change something, it's not very hard to do. You just straighten it back out, you know, and try again. It's very forgiving, which I really appreciate. So once you're done with that, it's going to look like it's laying flat here. It's really easy. Just take that and twist it up so that it's like this. And then you can take it and put it back on your vase. And then you can either stretch it out and have it go up to the top, or have it all like this. Just have it go around the bottom. Whatever you want to do, whatever floats your boat there. And like I said, and then you can take, at that point, you can use your glue dot if you want, or a hot glue gun, and just put a little dab of glue to keep this, you know, from moving around if you don't want it to move around at all. Or you just leave it loose so that's easier for you to take it off at the end of the wedding. And there you go. And then you can, of course, put whatever you want inside your vase. Some gems, some stones, glass beads, water beads, fairy lights, whatever. And there you go. An easy way to dress up a Dollar Tree vase. And if you guys have any questions, please feel free to leave me a message in the comments or message me directly on my Facebook page, Plum Crafty. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so that you get notifications anytime I upload a new video. Sorry about that, my video cut at the end. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Have a great day.